In this tutorial, you'll learn how to import and apply LUTs in Blackmagic Camera V3 on iOS and Android, which delivered a complete redesign of LUT functionality along with a new suite of creative LUTs available out of the box so you can get the film look in camera on your smartphone. LUT functionality now has a dedicated spot in the HUD directly beneath the lens picker. Tap to reveal the new suite of built-in creative LUTs. As soon as you swipe through them, they are applied as a display LUT. You can toggle your display LUT on and off at the top of the picker. Display LUTs are applied in the preview only and not your final recording. If you want to record a LUT to clip, enable Record LUT to clip at the bottom. Now what you see is what you get in your final recording. Ideal for fast workflows, but if you want the best results, turn this off and apply it in post using your favorite editing app. Now let's dig in and learn how to get the best possible results with Apple and Samsung LUG, which provide the greatest dynamic range as well as other benefits like decreased sharpening and no dynamic tone mapping in tandem with your own imported LUTs, which deliver a much better image than the stock creative LUTs applied to the standard Rec709 color space. Open Settings and under Record tap on Codec. If you're on an iPhone 15 or 16 Pro, choose between ProRes if you have plenty of storage space, or HEVC if you want smaller file size that still delivers the benefits of 10-bit color. If selecting HEVC, choose the max bitrate for highest quality. And if you're on the iPhone 17 Pro, you also have the option of 12-bit ProRes RAW to an external SSD, which will deliver the highest quality possible. And if you're on Android, select HEVC with max bitrate, then tap back. Next, under Color Space, if on an iPhone 15, 16 Pro or Pro Max, choose Apple LUG. If on the iPhone 17 Pro or Pro Max, choose Apple LUG 2. And if on Samsung, choose Samsung LUG. And on all other models of smartphone, choose Rec709. If we return to the camera, we have a washed out image, which is exactly what we want. And if you tap on LUTs, you can apply an Apple LUG or Samsung LUG to Rec709 conversion to assist you with exposure. However, while the built-in Rec709 conversion is fine as an exposure guide, it destroys skin tones and delivers an oversaturated and heavily contrasted look. Make sure Record LUT to Clip is disabled if using the built-in Rec709 LUT so you can dial in a nice image in post. If shooting in LUG, you probably care about your image and will want to import a custom LUT carefully crafted for Apple or Samsung LUG. To do this, return to Settings and scroll down to LUTs and tap on the LUT Manager. Here you can disable all Blackmagic built-in LUTs to hide them from the LUT picker in the camera HUD, or leave them enabled and just disable the ones you'll never use, for example, day-night. I personally never use stock LUTs, so I'm going to disable them all. To import your own LUTs, scroll down to the bottom of the LUT Manager and tap Import LUT. Use the Files browser to locate them on your device. Typically, if you've downloaded from the internet, they will automatically be saved to your downloads folder. I'll start by importing my GLOAT LUT, which is available for both Apple LUG and Samsung LUG. Choose the 33x version and tap on the .cube file to import it. The next thing you need to do for your LUT is choose the correct color space tag. Typically, most LUTs are designed for Rec709 as the final output color space, and this is selected by default. All Epic LUTs need a Rec709 color space tag. With your LUT imported, return to the camera, tap on the LUT HUD button, and your LUT can be selected and applied quickly from here. Again, for the greatest flexibility, apply it as a display LUT only, then apply later in post. However, if you need a quick turnaround, you can tap to enable Record LUT to Clip. Record LUT to Clip is not currently supported in Samsung LUG, but hopefully it will be in the future. Blackmagic Camera also supports bulk LUT import. To import multiple LUTs at once, return to Settings, LUTs, LUT Manager, scroll to the bottom, and tap Import LUT. This time I'll open the Apple LUG Jamming LUT Pack and select all 33x versions, then tap to open. And now they're all there and ready to go. If I return to the camera, you can cycle through your imported LUTs easily. And if you're importing multiple LUTs, this is why you'll probably want to disable Blackmagic's own to make it less unwieldy to navigate. If you want to remove an imported LUT, just return to the LUTs Manager under Settings and tap Remove LUTs at the very bottom. Then tap the X next to the LUT you want to remove and it's gone from the app, but still available to import later should you need it. We can also export LUTs, including Blackmagic's own creative LUTs, by tapping Export LUT from the LUTs Manager. This is a great way to make a LUT available to share with yourself in your editing app of choice, for example via an editor or LumaFusion on mobile, or Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve on desktop. So now you know how to master LUTs in Blackmagic Camera V3 on iOS and Android. I hope this video helped. If it did, please like and subscribe. If you want to master mobile filmmaking, let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. I've left a link in the pinned comment to Epic LUTs if you want the best LUTs for Apple and Samsung log. And if you'd like to support the channel, please become a member and come and continue the discussion on our members-only Discord. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.